Good Monday. I mentioned in a video yesterday that I was going to do a video about Pam. It's been around since 1959. It was invented by a guy named Arthur Meyerhoff. What you may not know, and it's kind of funny, what does Pam stand for? Well, Arthur Meyerhoff named it Product of Arthur Meyerhoff. So the next time you're in the store and you see a can of Pam, think fondly of Arthur Meyerhoff. Apparently, this is in like 95% of American households. And back in 2019, at least I saw a video of these supposedly exploding. Now, some of the cans back then had little vents on the bottom. The lawsuit's claiming those vents caused the can explode. The makers of Pam say that is not possible, that if the can is used properly, it won't explode. There are videos of it exploding. Long story short, no more vents in any of the cans. Why do people dislike Pam? If we look at the ingredients, there's... Where are my glasses? If we look at the ingredients, there's canola oil, that's okay. Coconut oil, that's okay. Palm oil, well, it all depends on how you feel about oil. Soy lecithin, any good kitchen that uses liquid shortening on their flat top grill, their liquid shortening has lecithin. And that just helps with nonstick properties. Here's the problem that people have. It has dimethyl silicone. If you look that up, apparently it's food safe. And it has propellant. People get upset that it has dimethyl silicone and propellant. I'm a recent user of Pam. I've been using it for the last couple of months. Before that, I didn't buy it. I bought it once, and I bought the Great Value brand. When I first got my Visions cookware, and I made scrambled eggs in my V9 skillet, I bought a can of Great Value cooking oil spray. It was great. The eggs just didn't stick to the pan. I didn't use it after that. I might have used it once, but the can sat on a shelf. It expired, and I threw it away. Too much information! A couple of months ago, you know, I was Googling seasoning carbon steel and seasoning cast iron. I came across a page describing how fans of Wagner and Griswold cast iron season their pans with Pam. That's why I did the video recently, seasoning my Taiwan cast iron with Pam. So I bought this a couple months ago, thinking that I would buy a large chef skillet and season it. So I didn't. I didn't buy the pan, but I still had bought the Pam. And then I thought, well, let's use the Pam on our carbon steel and our vintage aluminum griddle. And I started using it. This may be very bad for you, but boy, eggs don't stick. Pam is a low viscosity oil, and that means it flows. It flows like WD-40. I call it the WD-40 of cooking oils. It just soaks in, it spreads out. You don't have to use too much. You put your eggs in the pan, you can't even see the oil. They're like just sitting on top of the pan. It's pretty cool. So low viscosity, WD-40, cooking oil. So we're gonna cut to a compilation of me cooking eggs using Pam on aluminum, various pans, because it really is great stuff. A product of Arthur Meyerhoff. Cue video! only been using this a couple of months. It's wonderful stuff. It's not cheap. If you're afraid of food sticking in your new carbon steel or your Visions cookware, you might want to give PAM a try. I give it a thumbs up. If you're not worried about propellant and sodium dimethyl, I give it a thumbs up. If you're not worried about propellant and silicone, oh, I give it a thumbs up. If you're not worried about propellant and silicone, I give it a thumbs up if you're not worried about propellant and dimethyl silicone. Thanks for joining me this Monday. Thanks for watching.